Prime Minister Jacinda Ardern has been criticised from both sides of the political spectrum this week about her government's apparent lack of effective action on the housing crisis as house prices continue to go through the roof. So it'll probably come as no surprise that the housing market is the topic that National Party leader Judith Collins is very keen to talk about with us this morning. Morena, Ms. Collins, thank you for being in the studio with us. Okay, so what needs to be done about the housing crisis?
Well, there's some obvious things, the RMA reform that we've all talked about. I was going to say it, and there's a reason. I think everyone in government, in Parliament generally now, understands that that is actually one of the big problems. But the other thing is, too, Jenny May, is the incentivising or helping the councils to make the right decisions about opening up land and getting the buildings done. But there are real issues around at the moment because house prices just keep going up and up and up. And what we're seeing is that a lot of the extra lending that, or money that the Reserve Bank's putting into the market and to banks is going straight into existing houses rather than new builds, and certainly not into the business community, with $8.7 billion since March extra going into the already pumped up housing market. And $6.1 billion less going into productive businesses.
Well, and this is something that Andrew Bailey, which is your, who is your new shadow treasurer, has spoken about. And he says that the funding for lending program is targeted at, well, should be targeted at the more productive parts of our economies and our economy. And obviously you support that.
Oh, absolutely. And I think one of the things that we're seeing is that we are in extraordinary times, obviously, and this pumping money into the economy is a good thing to do. The problem is it going into the economy or is it just going into house prices? And that's the issue. So Australia, the UK, they've done similar things where the government has said, you've got to be a bit careful about what's going on here. But what we're seeing is the housing prices of existing houses are just getting more and going further and further through the roof.
Doesn't the Prime Minister have a point, though, when she says that mandating the Reserve Bank or penning a suggestive letter would violate the Reserve Bank's independence?
Well, I think she's wrong there, and I thought it was quite extraordinary that she said that. I mean, we've got people like Michael Cullen making observations around this too, but also I think it's important to remember is that Australia and the UK have done similar things, talking to their reserve banks. But when you've got the Reserve Bank also having moved from under this government, simply being focused on inflation rates, but now to employment, they've got a very mixed mandate anyway. And I think what people would want to see is that the Reserve Bank, if they're going to pump that sort of money into the trading banks, that they do actually focus on growing the economy, because I just think this housing bubble we've got now is just getting worse and worse, and what nobody wants to see is for that to burst and all of a sudden people having lost their life savings plus being left with debt.
So what should the government be doing exactly? Actually, let me rephrase it. What would you do?
Well, I think it's really important, obviously, to deal with the drivers of house prices. You'll well remember the Chinese-sounding names, which Labor ran in opposition under Phil Twyford, as an attack on housing. That certainly hasn't made any difference. But what you do need to do is absolutely reform the RMA, but also look at all the disincentives that councils now have to approving land being used for housing, and a lot of those around their own financial situation. So yeah, the government could do a lot more on this. But the other thing, stop lending to just continuously push up house prices.
So what reforms, you mentioned the reforms to the RMA, what reforms need to be done in order to help?
There's a tremendous amount there. So, for instance, streamlining approvals. And you've seen it already with the current government having to say, well, look, they wanted to bring in basically mass consent a whole lot of developments, because if they didn't do that, they would be waiting years and years and years for it. But the other thing is, a letter to the Reserve Bank to say, when you're pushing this money into the trading banks, how about you ask them to put a bit more effort into assisting businesses, but also even property developers who are putting in place new housing. Why not them? Why only existing housing where it's really easy for you to lend on, but actually it's not going to add to the housing market other than putting prices up.
Kua pau te wā ki a taua. Our time is up. However, I do want to ask you about how the review is going.
Oh, well, it's the National Party board is in charge of that, and that I think they're going to be making an announcement at our AGM that we've got this weekend at in Wellington. So I guess it'll be announced then.
Yep. So has it started?
Oh, I think part of it has. Certainly our MPs have been out talking to electorates and mostly listening to them as they've told us what they thought about what went right, what went wrong. There's probably more went wrong, yeah. But also their suggestions. So I've been doing that job along with the other MPs, and that's all going to form part of that review.
Is there a review panel that's been put in place?
There will be one announced, yeah. And but I'm not going to announce it today. The President can do that.
Yeah. Is there a Māori or Pacific presence on that?
I think you'll find that there is a good presence from people there, and hopefully you'll find that is sorted.
Ms. Collins, it's always a pleasure to have you on the show. Thank you so much for coming into the studio this morning.
Thank you. Tēnā koe.